Sven. Good job. I agree with your choice. He does not have that happening.
Check.
As the Bible reminds us in Peter,
Be completely humble and gentle. Be patient, bearing with one another in love. And in John, above all, love each other deeply, because love covers a multitude of sins. And in Philippians, I pray that your love for each other will overflow more and more, and that you will keep growing on your knowledge and understanding. Who gives this woman today to be joined in marriage? And who gives this man to be joined in marriage? Marriage is more than a simple exchanging of rings. Today you'll be legally bound together. But the bonds of commitment you make today are far deeper and stronger than it can easily be put into words. Marriage is one of life's greatest gifts, and it is a privilege and a gift to make these promises to each other today. As you begin your married life together, your intention should be to grow in knowledge and love of one another. As we gather here today to witness this commitment Andrew and Amanda are making to each other, it's the perfect moment to explore what makes them the wonderful couple we all know them to be. Determined, devoted, extraordinary people, mouse, egg-centric because they both love eggs. Charismatic, fitting, committed, loving, and symbiotic. And I think you'll all agree that if we consider these words together, it perfectly fits the compelling narrative of how these two wonderful people met, the story of Amanda and Andrew. So Amanda decided to go on an adventure by herself to Australia. She went off to the other side of the world and arrived in the beautiful city of Brisbane on the east coast. After one night in Brisbane, she realised she needed to see the real Australia, which meant she needed to be closer to a beach. So she dragged her very large, oversized, cumbersome, three wobbly-wheeled bag onto a train and took a two-hour train journey to the Gold Coast. She didn't pre-book any accommodation, so she arrived and found that all the hostels were full. She thought she'd try motels. They were also all booked out. And so were the expensive hotels. So she decided she needed to find somewhere to couch surf. The always entrepreneurial Andrew had recently listed his Gold Coast couch on a newly minted website for couch surfers. And as fate would have it, Amanda found Andrew. She was quickly drawn into his adventurous and free-spirited nature and spent longer, much longer than planned, at Andrew's house. Word has it that one of the groomsmen may have been the world's greatest wingman and cancelled some of the future bookings Amanda had made at other hostels. And that is the start of what brings us here today. Andrew and Amanda, these words and experiences form the foundations upon which you will build your future together. I invite you, in the presence of your family and friends, to publicly declare your commitment to one another. Amanda and Andrew, I now invite you to publicly speak your commitment to your partner. Would you like to begin?
Andrew, you're my rock, my support that I can always count on, my adventure partner. You help me to live life to the fullest and remind me that all goals are achievable. You encourage me to be bold, to think big, even though I tend to think of the smallest details first. You've helped me to learn consistency, to be structured and prepared. You provide me praise and compliments at all the perfect times. I admire the goals you set with intention and achieved with hard work and dedication. The wisdom you seek and gain through thoroughness. I thank you for always being there for me. knowing what I need before I know I need it. For the cuddles, kisses, surprises, and sweet gestures. Thank you for being my love. Today, before our family and friends, I make a commitment to you to protect our relationship through practicing patience and kindness, to prioritize us as one, and to love you forever.
Amanda. Ever since the first day that I met you, I knew that you were the perfect match for me, and that I would move heaven and earth to make this possible. Chances are that I have done that. Now we're here, so I just want you to know that I'll continue doing that for the rest of our lives together. And I love you so much, and I'll never forget the day we met.
Would you two now join hands? Andrew, do you take Amanda to live together in the union of marriage, to take her as your best friend and partner in life, to honor, cherish, and love for all of your days?
I do.
You're better.
Amanda, do you take Andrew to live together in the union of marriage, to take him as your best friend and partner in life, to honor, cherish, and love him from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, for all of your days?
I do. I give you this ring as a symbol of my love, as I place it on your finger, I commit the whole of my heart and soul to you. I promise to cherish you. I commit the whole of my heart and soul to you. I promise to cherish you for the rest of my days. I give you all that I am, and I accept all that you are.
I give you this ring as a symbol of my love. As I place it on your finger, I commit the whole of my heart and soul to you. I promise to cherish you for the rest of my days. I give you all that I am, and I accept all that you are.
The wedding ring is a symbol which solidifies your promise that you made to Amanda in Hat Head National Park on the 10th of January 2015. Please place her engagement ring in its place. Family and friends, by the power vested in me by the Universal Life Church and by the State of California, I'm pleased to announce Andrew Fife and Amanda Marie as husband and wife, sealed together today, both in love and in law. And so I declare them to be husband and wife. You may kiss your bride. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Andrew and Amanda Lamont.
To the top, and suddenly the rain stopped. And we sat at the, we found a nice bench to sit on, and it was overlooking our home that we grew up in, and just kind of took in the beautiful view. And that's just what I love so much about you, because you're such a good motivator. Even when people are hesitant to do things, you just push people to do what they were, to climb that mountain.
Yes.
And I know that you guys are perfect together, because you both are, you just push each other to be better.
Yep. Whoa. Yep.
And you're always able to see the big picture, and I just love you two as a couple. It's just beautiful to see that you found the person that you're meant to be with. And then I'll pass it off to Jenny.
Oh, thanks.
Jenny.
Yeah, Jenny.
Jenny.
Are you guys ready to play a game?
Uh oh.
All right, I'm going to give you three scenarios.
Oh, no.
Uh-oh. And by show of hands, you'll let me know which you think is false. All right?
Say that again.
Which is false?
Which one's false?
Okay.
All right, so while traveling through Panama, Andy and Amanda lived entirely off of coconuts due to what we'll call insufficient funds. Okay, that's one. Rode camels through Australia's outback, because why not? Rode her motorbike through Bali, almost losing a leg in the process. I'm exaggerating a little bit. And last, invented electricity.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. So I really couldn't come up with anything they haven't done. Or I can't come up with anything they wouldn't do, probably. And this really extends to family and friends as well. I don't know how to juggle yet. They opened up their home to me last year as I traveled through Australia and supported me through what I'll call a quarter-life crisis. We have those now. Yes, and through this time, I got a first-hand look at this couple, close and personal.
Yeah.
They probably wanted to get rid of me.
No.
Time.
No.
I'm clean. So. And it inspired me, really seeing their relationship. It really did. I learned a lot between you two. It wasn't the plan. And yeah, so I really just got to see this like supportive, loving foundation. And I really appreciate it. There's more. I'm thrilled that she has found someone that keeps up, if not surpasses, her pace. It brings out her best qualities. Yeah. But then we love it though, Amanda. So cheers.
Cheers.
Woo!
The bride groom.
Practice speech in at the box party. And I was just getting to the part where I was going to say that Amanda has just such a fun personality. When the skipper interrupted and he said, "Hey guys, blue algae." So if anyone has any need to alert the groom's party to any nearby marine biology, speak now or forever hold your peace. Anyway, firstly, I'd like to say how beautiful the groomsmen are. I mean, look at us. Pretty good. Pretty good. I'm kidding, of course. It's quite clear that men get the easy route in most things. For one, we don't have to spend $300 on a haircut and only have to throw on a suit. We also get lost without you. I mean that literally. It's funny, males will have you believe we're the superior gender when we're navigating, but at the moment you aren't in the room, we have no idea where we are. There's a reason they made Siri a woman. So you get the point, males often get the easy way out. So Amanda, on behalf of every male here, and in case Andy doesn't say it frequently enough, we understand we get the easy way out. And more importantly, you and your bridal party look absolutely gorgeous tonight, and always.
Pretty good, isn't it?
Thank you. Gunda's wedding is essentially a blend of two cultures. I'm going to conduct a lesson in communication today. I think there are three main things we can all learn from this relationship. Here is the first. Speaking to all the Americans, hands up. I want to warn you, this marriage is going to be very difficult for you. Australians have one of the most confusing vernaculars in the world. I'm going to preemptively resolve any issues that might arise by teaching you some of Andy's common phrases.
Oh, Jesus.
Let's pretend I'm you having a conversation with him. Hi, Andrew. How's your day been? Oh, yeah, no. This means yes, good, thanks. Oh. And then you say, have you been busy at work? Oh, no, yeah. This means not really. And you think, wow, this is awkward. Amanda's married some monochromatic kangaroo. Oh, fuck. You get desperate and bring up politics. Oh. Say, Andy, what do you think of Donald Trump? And he says, yeah, no. And this just means no. So the message is simple. Oh. Watch out for his language. Because when he says, yeah, she goes all right, it actually means I'm desperately in love with her. The second lesson is for the Australians here.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Last night, not before actually, Andy and Amanda were at our hotel. They're about to leave and have to strategically exit the conversation. Amanda turns to Andy and says, you ready to go, dude? And Andy says, you don't call your life partner dude. Amanda says, why not? You can be my dude and my lover at the same time. So Australians, chill out, live life a little bit, Californian dude. To me, what's very special today, aside from putting on a suit and looking gorgeous, is the merging of two very different families that share similar values, respect, integrity, honesty. Somehow Amanda understands Andy. She's patient and loving when he's energetic, sad, confused, upset, hungover. Hungover. Upset. Hungover. Upset. Hungover again. Honestly, Amanda, I don't know how you deal with them. It might be like riding a bull. I mean, wait, is it? And Andy is thoughtful and loyal. Sorry, that was a bit much.
Oh, fucking hell.
Andy's thoughtful and loyal, sticking through Amanda's hardest challenges. When she calls him at 2 in the morning after having lost Fritz at an enormous Californian party, he's able to calm her and steady the ship 5,000 miles away. I'd like to say thanks to Valerie and Bob for bringing up a daughter so perfect for my brother to marry, and thanks to Mum and Dad for somehow producing a man handsome enough to commit so that the Lamonts aren't such a bad bunch. All jokes aside, the third lesson from this relationship. Andy, Amanda, I believe the single greatest asset you have together is the way you foster each other's goals. You support each other to reach your potential in your careers, friendships, and health. And I think we can all learn from that. Andy, as a younger brother, I'm very proud. And Amanda, I have every confidence you will look after him like no one else I know can. So everyone, let's toast to Andy and Amanda, to a life of bigger goals achieved together. Woo!
Peaceful and deep. Let's give him a round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Good job, Dad. Very good. All right, very good. And what would a wedding be without the parents? We need the parents for all this to happen. So we're going to do it.